Hello. We're gonna carry on. We're gonna carry on with the third piece of the project I'm now calling just Scandinavians. And it's my project based on my feelings about the book or the poem Beowulf. So I was just a quick story before I dive into this. It's not really a story, but it's an anecdote. My friend Izzy, whom you should definitely check out on Twitch, it's Effin Izzy, EFFIN, I think underscore, and IZZY, and he's also a composer, and he just put out a series of really great piano improvisations. So you should check that out. And if you're in the mood to spend some money on someone that you know is on Bandcamp, like Izzy, now is a good time to do it. I don't know if you know about this, but every month or so, Bandcamp has a Friday. They choose a Friday, and where any money that is spent in a one 24-hour period, they usually take out 15% revenue share for themselves, which is, really amazingly great. It's just great. I love Bandcamp. But if you get them on this particular day, 100% of the money goes directly to the artist, which it's how do you make a generous offer even more generous, and that's how you do it. I love Bandcamp, and they've been great to us musicians. And so if you're going to help out your fellow musicians, composers, songwriters, bands who are on Bandcamp, do it right now. I know there's no one in the chat right now, so I don't know where to talk. I hope you get this in time, but there's a great. If you type in one word, is it Bandcamp Friday yet? Question mark. Then it gives you this fun web page that counts you down until the next one. So it's happening right as I'm recording this right now. So I just dumped a ton of money that I made recently onto my friend's pieces. So we like to turn it around. They've been really great to me. We support each other, so I throw that money back at them to buy their stuff, and I get to listen to cool music. Okay, anyway, enough of that. So what are we doing? So this is called Scandinavians. And I think the next part in the book that I kind of want to capture is there's this moment when it's after Grendel has something like 12 years or something. I have to go look it up again, but there's this period where Grendel is terrorizing the mead hall, Heorot. I think it's pronounced Heorot. Oh, I didn't even get to my story, my anecdote. Izzy, I gotta stay focused. Izzy, I told Izzy yesterday about this project, and the minute I said Beowulf, he said, "Ah, Beowulf." And on his podcast or on his Twitch stream, he immediately says, "Oh yeah, our teacher taught us to memorize the first section of the Old English of that." So he launches into this amazing, perfect Old English pronunciation. It just rolls off his tongue, and I was just. I was agape. It was amazing. I didn't know anyone really did that except like Beowulf scholars, and I know two Beowulf scholars personally. And I thought only they could recite the Old English, but Izzy just tore into this beautiful Old English, and he's my new hero now. So I'm bad at memorizing stuff like that. but I think I might try, maybe just I'll find a website or something. I don't know. I want to learn how to do that because it was the coolest thing ever. And now that I'm working on this project, it might be good if I had some of it memorized. So yeah, there's my anecdote to get warmed up. Okay, so let's start. So the first thing I'm going to do is I was on the bus the other day and I just recorded a really kind of, it's going to be kind of crummy, but it doesn't need to be high quality recording. But I just recorded the vibrations in the bus because I had earphones on and the vibrations were coming in. I don't know if it's going to capture it. We'll find out when I kind of dig into this sound clip, but it's an entire bus ride up from the bottom of the mountain to the campus where I work. We'll just see. And there are some voices in the track that I'm going to try to filter out and just get to the kind of meaty, grindy vibrations of the bus. We'll see what comes of it. I haven't listened to it yet, so I hope it isn't a complete disaster like the last recording I made. And then I'm going to try to lay on some strings. So I'll explain later the moment in the book that I'm interested in. But let's start with that. Let's lay in that noise track. And it doesn't like MP4s. Since when? Yeah, what a drag. This is starting off really badly already. Great. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is throw you back to that song we were playing, and I'm going to go out of here and try to do it on Cubase, convert it, because I don't really have a converter for this. So I'll see you soon. Okay, it worked. I didn't use Cubase. I used Shotcut, which is a great video editor that is open source, free, and I love it. I use it for all video things, and sometimes I use it as a file converter, and it worked really well. So here we go. There it is, the waveform and everything. So let's get to work. Let's hear how this sounds. All right, so I'm not really interested in those voices at all, unless they're just kind of garbled beyond recognition, which is fine. So I think I might be able to shear those off with EQ. That's the deal. That's nice. So I don't know how this thing is going to evolve. It's not going to this sound. It's not going to stay static. It's going to move around and peak and valley and stuff and like that. put a rein on it with compression. I just got some good news. I consider it good news about the election in the U.S. But this is not a political broadcast, so I'll keep it to myself. I don't mind that it kind of ebbs and flows and, you know, goes up and down, surges and stuff. That could be dramatic. I could write around that. But I am going to put it further down in the mix. Okay, I should probably let you in on what I'm going for here. There's this part in the poem where, you should probably be familiar with Beowulf. I'm not going to catch you up because I talked about it before. Grendel is the monster that, at the beginning, doesn't like that they're all celebrating and stuff, so he goes in and kills everyone, and he basically owns the hall now, the mead hall. And this happens, I think it says, for 12 winters or something like that, 11 or 12 winters, which is a long time to, you know, to be kind of in fear of this creature. And I don't know why they keep going back to drink, and they say something about boasting, like, oh, we're going to go fight the monster when they get drunk. And then, of course, he comes in and wipes them out. And it's amazing how long they let this go on, and that it took Beowulf 12 years. Maybe I'm getting it wrong. I have to go back to that. But anyway, that doesn't change what I'm going for here, that the mead hall goes silent, and it's supposed to be the grandest meeting place in the land, and, you know, built by the king, and it's supposed to celebrate the glories, and in those times the mead hall was kind of the landmark of where everybody kind of gathers and shares stories, and it's kind of a symbol of their pride, I guess, and where they can tell stories and things, which is a big, you know, that was where it happened. The grandest hall in the land. And it was reduced, because of this terror, reduced to a silent reminder of death and destruction. So I'm just imagining this hall that was built for glory and just beautifully decked out with, you know, just in the best way they could imagine, and broken and wrecked and blood spattered, and just a silent husk of what it was. And I'm just imagining being there as a fly on the wall or something, when at the moments where there's nothing. And the feelings of what it used to be, of what it could be, could have been, are just lying in tatters. It's kind of how I imagine, I'm maybe reaching a bit here, but I think I remember seeing pictures or video of when the Olympics were held in Sarajevo. Shortly after that, the infrastructure of the Olympic parks and things that they had built quickly fell into disrepair, and they became this sort of ruin of what Yugoslavia could have been, and just I know I'm probably going to go back and go, no, you got this wrong, corrections and stuff. But anyway, that's just kind of what I imagined, kind of like a ghost town, but in, medieval Scandinavia. So this is the moment I'm hoping to capture in this piece. So, well, that's where I'm going with this. Lots of talking this time, huh? Let's do a little composition. All I've got is this noise. But okay, I'm gonna add on, maybe I'm gonna do a little string improvisation here with sounds and try to put together a chordal, a tonal kind of language for this song. All right, let's start with that then. I'll do a little testing and then start improvising a bit. Okay, it looks like the sound works. All right, just kind of getting a feel. I think I'm gonna lay in some cellos first. And I've already done the piece that introduces Grendel. So, good. So I already know what kind of sounds indicate Grendel. So there are going to be echoes of that in here because he might not actually be here in the empty hall. I think, he takes his prey and goes back to his hole or his cave or whatever, and he devours them. So I think he just comes here to hunt. So this is the empty hall. Similar to kind of what I imagined the empty, sea cliffs. But this is just an empty hall. It might smell bad. And if there are any echoes, there's kind of things falling apart, or maybe rats and other scavenging critters coming in to kind of partake of what's left over. So, yeah, stuff like that. Those are the only sounds we're going to hear, and it's an echoing hall, so it's going to be pretty stark. Okay. Thank you. This is the Grendel bit. Okay, that's something to work from. Sorry about the silence. I'm just going to test out a couple patches. I know what I'm doing wrong. Okay, let's have a bash, shall we? Start again. I like that, just the way it is. Okay, I think that was pretty good. Okay. Like some of the things that were happening, I might not tweak it later, but it's good thing to start with. Okay, I've found an old recording that I made of rain, and I was going to use it in the last piece, but I didn't. I ended up using a thunderstorm. So maybe I'll try that out. And here it is. It looks like it's got some spikies in there, which might be good for the texture. Let's listen. Just going to try out a few filters and effects and things. I'm just kind of looking at the more prominent sections of this sample, see what happens. I couldn't remember what the- I couldn't remember what the Nightbot trigger was for in chat for recommendations, so I tried a bunch of things. Okay, I'm gonna go set up the mic. I think I'm gonna do some trumpet stuff with this. Got no idea what it's gonna be, but I'm just gonna try some things. Oh, that's lovely. But too long, I think. Oh, I know what it is. It's the dub. Okay, well, it's good to get this set of things. We'll get this thing set up. Yeah, I can speak English. It's always something really simple that I'm overlooking. Right? it's gonna hit me like a pie in the face when I figure it out. But of course, it is the.
It was, of course, the Phantom Power. The Phantom Power.
Let's try again. Of course not. I just want to see how that sounds. Okay, not too bad. I don't know about this. Sounds pretty cheesy. It's not what I want at all, really. Thank you. Okay, it's a start. It's not finishing it today, so I'm just gonna. Ooh, wow. It's not finishing it today, so I'm going to stop for now and pick it up tomorrow. So, thanks everyone for watching this video in the future. And if you get a chance, if you see me on, come on by and throw something in the chat. Talk to you later. Thanks.